Hello everyone and welcome back to another Grey Man Travels adventure, and today we're on a new mod map that's taken us to another planet. Ooh. So this mod map is called Mars The Mission. It is cross-platform compatible, so PC, Mac, PlayStation 4, PlayStation 5, Xbox One and the Xbox series of consoles. It was released today on the 12th of the 3rd 2024. It's under version 1.0.0.0. It's only 107.52 megabytes to download, so quite nice and small, and you'll see why in a moment. And it's put together by a pretty well-known map maker and mod maker called Farmer Bob. So he's done quite a few maps, and he does quite a few tutorial series on YouTube for everybody to watch, so it's pretty cool. So we've got a little bit of a blurb on Mod Hub, but nothing major. So first off, we've got, "Welcome to the Mars Colony, Commander. This map is all about survival, so put your man pants on and let's get started." Okay, our man pants are on. "Features one farmland, 15 fields, 3 factories, 1 sale point. Only new farmer mode supported in this map, the others are irrelevant. Use the export to Earth port to sell your products and fruit to Earth, and the colony food storage for storing your fruit for the colony." So I think they're both over in the corner over there. So it says, "To win the game, you need to terraform Mars atmosphere in 20 years. To achieve this, you have to plant 10,000 trees, have 20 large beehives, 160 cows, 720 chickens, 195 sheep, 540 pigs and 800,000 litres of each of any 6 crops in your storage bin." So 800,000 litres each of any 6 crops. Okay, so not too bad. And that's pretty much it. So yeah, it's a very interesting idea and something really completely unique. So I think what we'll do, let's get our feet kind of back down on the ground, but we'll be on Martian soil, and see what our starting farm and starting equipment looks like. So we start with an awful lot of equipment, to be honest with you, but I can understand why, because you'd probably, I'm not sure you'd take these sort of tractors to Mars or equipment to Mars, but oh well. So we start with a Fendt small tractor, lots of Massey Ferguson and JCB medium. Start with a nice T560 John Deere combine, a cotton harvester by Case, skid steer by New Holland, Mahindra, a little wagon, lots of trailers, the Welga, the Rudolph and the Crone, the corn header and also the normal header, sorry, that header and the corn header, all good. The stone picker from Elho, a cultivator, we've got the Pottinger seeder, we've got a planter, we've got sprayers, the normal Breedel fertilizer spreader, a manure spreader, slurry tank, forage wagon, forestry equipment for your planting of your trees and your saplings, a couple of animal tanks for your milk and water and herbicide, etc., skid steer tools and some weights. So no lease items either, but yeah, a bit unusual. So I'm not going to run around this map too much, but as you can see, your whole farm is in a dome. So if I have a quick look on the actual PDA itself, it'll make a bit more sense. So we own pretty much everything by the looks of it. So yeah, it's kind of a bit strange in a way. The fields have already been purchased. You've then got independent domes inside the main dome, which is around the outside, which is interesting, I must admit. So you've got your animals here as well, I think. If I look, let's put trainers, tools, animals and contracts on. Yeah, you see where you've got all your different productions, all your bits of equipment, you've got your different domes, you've got an equipment dome here as well, you've got your pigs, you've got your sheep, you've got your hare, chickens and your cows. So pretty cool. So crop calendar wise, it is pretty standard. Nothing has been changed massively by the looks of it. Nothing's been added, nothing's been removed, so you can grow whatever you want on Martian soil. Everything kind of goes to the export to Earth, or you can take it to a production. So like flour and butter can go to the bakery, but everything else can go export to Earth, or you can do a bale cellar, spinnery, oil mill, etc. So you've got pretty base game stuff on here, so it's pretty cool. Animals is a lot of animals, but obviously that kind of makes sense. So if we run through where they are quickly, so I'm pretty certain we've got cow barn, a feeding robot, the base game one. 80, that's an 80 head. I'm guessing the other one are going to be an 80 head, but you're all inside this dome, so it's pretty cool. Yeah, 80 head. And here we've got chickens, chicken coop, base game one, so both the same. 360, so not too bad at all. And then sheep, we've got three of the same again. Large sheep barn, 65 heads, so three of those. And then pigs, we've got 270, two of those. So again, pretty good, pretty good. PDA wise, not really much to talk about. You're inside a big dome on the Martian surface. You've got independent domes there and around here with animals, equipment, etc. in them. So, and then you've got all these fields. What you've got? 1, 2, 13. It says 15 fields. 13, 14, 15, sorry. So, yeah, not really anything massively revolutionary. Let's have a quick look what we've got on the PDA itself there on the map. We've got vehicle sales and repairs, so like a shop, bale sales, spinnery, we've got the animal dealer, and we've got a vehicle shop. So that's all inside this dome. So quite cool though, I must admit. Nice idea. Then over here we have a bakery, a spinnery, a grape processing unit, an oil mill, electric charging station, Karma 16 silo, another one, probably liquid fertilizer tank, stainless steel fertilizer tank, large greenhouse, MKS, and below that, take the vehicles off, trailers, and three large greenhouses. So all pretty good. Over here we've got a water tank, a farmer 800, a farmer, and a farmer, so all the silos. Electric charging station, that's our equipment dome. There's our animals. Over here we've got our lime station, our debris crusher, then we've got a sawmill, and that's a forestry plot of land there, I must admit. So that's pretty cool. Export to Earth, where you can sell everything. You've then got a gas station and electric charging station. You also actually have your farmhouse out here. So still inside the dome, even though you're not quite sure it is. But yeah, caravan on Mars. I like it. So looking down at the rest of the map, you obviously own all the productions that we've just run through. So we've got all the productions here. So your bakery, your large greenhouse, etc. So all pretty good. Don't have any contracts, but that kind of makes sense because you kind of wouldn't have any contracts because you're on Mars and you own the plot of land that you're trying to farm. So pretty unusual, I must admit. I mean, I think what we'll do though, we'll probably quickly fly around again. Get ourselves on to like 10 times, I think. We'll probably put flight mode on. There's no point in driving around. So we're on this top ledge here. A nice satellite dish there with all the different domes for all the different types of animals. We've got our fields, we've got our bit of forestry, we've got to plant some more trees anyway. And then we've got our crane, a construction site, we've got a big water silo there. Looks like some kind of mast here. I think that's supposed to be the way to get in and out of the dome, but you can't really go through there even in flight mode. So yeah, a pretty unusual map with some very unusual features for farming on another planet. So hopefully you've enjoyed this map tour. If you have, give it a like, subscribe to the Grey Man channel, and I hope to see you again soon. Many thanks for watching.